Top 6 Real Changes Because of Quarantine. In 2020, the world changed. A respiratory disease known as COVID-19 broke out in Wuhan, China, and spread across the globe within a matter of days. This outbreak was quickly declared a global pandemic by the World Health Organization, and governments quickly urged citizens to quarantine for the safety of the public. Despite the circumstances, quarantining does have its benefits. More places deliver food right to your door. Movies are airing on our TVs at home. Work and school can be done from the comfort of your bed or couch, and so on. Humans aren't the only ones benefiting from this change, though. Earth is doing a bit of healing, too. While many memes about this have been circulating, most are false. But today, we're going to be taking a look at some of the environmental changes actually happening. Before we get started, please don't forget to like and subscribe. And thanks for watching. 6. Empty roads and transportation hubs. Flights have dropped up to 70% and the roads are clearer than ever due to the quarantine, leading to less travel-related deaths. More and more people are having to work from home, and plenty of students are having to complete their schoolwork from home. So really, the only people on the streets are essential workers and grocery shoppers. While this comes at the cost of an extremely infectious respiratory disease, it is still worth celebrating that the amount of plane crashes and car wrecks have significantly decreased. 5. Decreased carbon dioxide emissions. Another positive side effect of the quarantine is the decreased emission of carbon dioxide due to the decreased activities in the coal and oil industries. Shandong Province's operations were at their lowest since 2015 due to the lockdown, and other power plants had coal consumption at a 4-year low. Thanks to this, carbon dioxide emissions were 25% lower around the time of the Lunar New Year compared to last year. While there's nothing wrong with celebrating the small victories, these 2 weeks only reduced annual totals by about 1%. 4. Venice canals cleaned up. Due to the quarantine, less and less people are visiting tourist hotspots, which is actually having a few positive effects. The Venice canals are clearer than they've been in the last 60 years, according to a spokesperson for the Italian city. This is thanks to the lack of traffic in the water, as all the boats going up and down the canals constantly stirred up sediment. If you're itching for a vacation with some gorgeous surroundings once you're done being locked in your bedroom, you should definitely keep Venice in mind. 3. Animals reclaiming land. In Llandudno, Wales, the streets are barren thanks to the quarantine, allowing some of the wildlife to wander freely once more. With the humans all stuck inside, herds of goats have been flocking to the vacant town center. The curious animals are just wondering what's going on like everybody else, town councillor Carol Marubi told BBC. This isn't the only place with curious animals roaming the streets, though, as wild turkeys have reportedly been showing up in parks across Oakland, and cichlid deer exploring beyond their habitat in Nara, Japan. 2. Less fog in Jakarta. Jakarta, Indonesia's capital city, is ranked as the city with the worst air pollution in the world. Thanks to the quarantine, however, a photo of Jakarta in 2020's pandemic compared to a photo of Jakarta just last year is wildly different, showing the decreasing fog levels. The beautiful skyline, once tainted by smoky gray clouds, has slowly regained its blue sky. Again, this doesn't mean the air is clean or safe now, but it is definitely a small step in the right direction. 1. Decreased prices. Unfortunately, not everything has decreased in price, but a couple of things certainly have. People have mostly been at home following quarantine guidelines. They rarely take their cars out unless they really need to. The decreased demand for gasoline has led to price drops across the entire country, with some states like Mississippi, Iowa, and Michigan selling gas for less than a dollar. Due to picking houses being closed, the demand for seafood has also decreased, causing crabbers and fishermen to lower their prices in attempts to bring in more customers. mortgage rates have also been the lowest since 1971, falling at an average 3.23% for a 30-year fixed-rate loan. A year ago, the average for a 30-year mortgage was at 4.14%. But good luck getting that loan, because banks and lenders are becoming stricter about who they lend their money to. These are volatile times, and who knows if you'll still be able to keep your job tomorrow. Despite the circumstances, quarantine has definitely had some positive effects on society and Mother Nature. While we of course wish anyone well who is struggling with COVID-19 or has family members that are, and thank all the medical professionals and essential workers for putting their lives on the line and keeping things functioning smoothly, we can also appreciate the small but significant step towards a healing process that the Earth seems to be taking. While this doesn't mean that climate change will stop being a problem and you can throw out your recycling bin, it does mean that there might be more hope for our beloved celestial planet than we thought. We just have to continue doing what's best for the planet beyond the quarantine. If you enjoyed today's video, please leave a like and subscribe, and thank you for watching.
10 most dangerous and treacherous places on Earth. While the universe continues to endlessly expand, and is filled with an unfathomable number of stars, planets, and many variations of space rocks, zooming all the way in on our home, Earth, is just as fascinating. As fascinating as Earth is, however, it is equally dangerous. From volcanoes ready to scorch the Earth in molten lava, to trenches so deep the water pressure would be unbearable. So today, we're going to be taking a look at the 10 most dangerous and treacherous places on Earth. Before we get started, please remember to leave a like if you enjoyed today's video, and subscribe. 10. Jerakbolten, Norway. Jerakbolten is a boulder on the mountain of Jerag in Norway. The boulder is a 5 cubic meter glacial deposit wedged in one of the crevices in the mountain. Several ice ages that occurred in Scandinavia have reshaped the valley a whopping 22 times, leaving behind relics such as this one. This intriguing site is at the top of our list because it isn't actively dangerous though. In fact, many people hike their way up the mountain to stand on Jerakbolten. But you definitely don't want to be around if and when the boulder finally does come crashing down. 9. Afar Triangle, Ethiopia. Next up we have the Afar Triangle, also referred to as the Afar Depression, is a low area that borders the Red Sea. This area contains the lowest point in Africa, Lake Assal, Djibouti, coming in at 509 feet below sea level. From November to February, the temperature here stays around 77 degrees Fahrenheit, but outside of the brief rainy season, the heat gets turned up severely. The dry season can leave the area as hot as 118 degrees Fahrenheit. Volcanoes, lava lakes, and earthquakes are common here, and merely the wind in this area blowing on your skin can leave a burning sensation. 8. Bikini Atoll, the Marshall Islands. Bikini Atoll, also known as Escholtz Atoll, is a coral reef in the Marshall Islands. The reef consists of 23 islands that surround a 230-square-mile lagoon. Bikini Island consisted of about 100 residents in 1970, but all were evacuated in 1980. In 1977, scientists found dangerous amounts of strontium-90 in the well water. Scientists also found that the residents were carrying high amounts of cesium-137 in their bodies. This was due to the fact that the United States tested 23 different nuclear weapons across 7 test sites on the reef, both underwater and in the air. While the radiation is dangerous and the residents have been evacuated, divers, scientists, and caretakers do still hang around. 7. Sinabung Volcano, Indonesia. Coming in at number 7, we have the Sinabung Volcano in Indonesia. It last erupted 1,200 years ago, but it's been showing signs of increased activity lately. In 1912, the volcano began spewing out hot sulfuric gases, but things would continue to escalate into the 2000s. Volcanoes do not need to erupt in order to be deadly, as a fast-moving current of gas and volcanic matter, known as pyroclastic flow, killed 7 people in 2016. Just 1 year prior, 10,000 people nearby were evacuated due to fears of an imminent eruption. The volcano has recently erupted again as of May and June of 2019. 6. Blue Hole, Belize. The Great Blue Hole is a giant sinkhole off the coast of Belize that sinks 125 meters deep into the Earth's crust. The site became popular when it was named one of the top 5 scuba diving spots in the world by Jacques Cousteau, a French naval officer. While this site is obviously a large tourist attraction for that reason, it is no stranger to accidents and fatalities. An estimated 130 to 200 divers have lost their lives at the Blue Hole. This is due to the complex underwater arches, could easily trap and kill experienced and inexperienced scuba divers. Divers may also venture too deep and may end up developing nitrogen narcosis, which can impair judgment and induce overconfidence, euphoria, hallucinations, and confusion. Should you ever go scuba diving here, make sure to follow all the safety precautions and do not go deeper than recommended, as it could end terribly. 5. Husseini Bridge, Pakistan. For number 5, we have the Husseini Bridge in Pakistan, known as the most dangerous bridge in the world. The bridge literally looks like something off an Indiana Jones movie. It is made of wooden planks tied together with enough space in between the planks for a small person or child to fall through. Traversing this bridge is definitely something that may be seen as a challenge by a brave few. Oh wait, did you know that the locals cross this bridge every day? Men, women, the elderly, and children. This bridge is just another part of their everyday lives. 4. The Door to Hell, Turkmenistan. The Door to Hell is an aptly named crater in Turkmenistan that has been on fire for over 45 years. The fiery glow can be seen from miles away and seems to show no sign of slowing down. The crater was created in 1971 when an underground gas cavern was mistakenly drilled into by a Soviet drilling rig. To head a natural catastrophe, the Soviets lit the hole on fire, expecting the burning to stop within a few days. But clearly Mother Nature had other plans. Going inside of this burning hole, filled with ever-present flames and poisonous gases, would be a death wish. Tourists do gather to appreciate the sight from a distance, complaining that even from afar, the heat emanating from the Door to Hell is scorching. 3. The Forest of Stone Knives, Madagascar. Starting off our top 3 is the Forest of Stone Knives in Madagascar. Even the highest quality of gloves is no match for the sharp limestone structures, towering 300 feet in the air. Formerly known as Singi de Bamaraha National Park, meaning the place where one cannot walk, in honor of the spiky limestone landscape. Home to dozens of local rare species and another tourist attraction, the Forest of Knives sounds scarier than it is, but is still a dangerous place to roam nonetheless. Climbing the spiky range is a challenge only experienced adventurers should take on. 2. Death Valley, Chile. Coming in at our number 2 spot is Death Valley. While there are tons of places with this fairly cliche name in the world, this time we are referring to the one in Chile. Also known as Mars Valley, it got its grim name from the fact that people who dared to try crossing before died in the process. Sand dunes and rocky natural formations fill the land, and not a single plant or insect is to be found. With high temperatures and a barren wasteland, this isn't a place you'd want to end up lost in. But as almost every other entry on this list, it is now a tourist attraction, mostly for sandboarding and hiking. 1. Mariana Trench. Finally, in our number 1 spot, we have the Mariana Trench, located in the Western Pacific Ocean. It is the deepest oceanic trench on Earth, coming in at 7 miles deep, or a little over 36,000 feet. The trench is so deep, if you were to put Mount Everest at the bottom, its peak would still be over a mile below the surface. The water pressure at the bottom is more than 1,071 times the atmospheric pressure when it's sea level. We have launched man thousands of miles into space. However, we are still incapable of sending man 7 miles deep into the ocean. The amount of water pressure is so severe that by the time you reach the bottom, you would basically be a ball of flesh and bone. And even your bones would eventually disappear, as they are eaten by bone-eating snotflower worms that usually devour whale bones. This concludes today's video on the top 10 most dangerous and treacherous places on Earth. Are there any other dangerous places you've heard of or been to? Have you been to any of the places in today's list? Let us know in the comments below. Please leave a like if you enjoyed today's video. Don't forget to subscribe and thank you for watching. 10 Most Insane Guinness World Records. The Guinness Book of World Records made its first appearance in 1995 and has been giving us annual updates on the accomplishments of man, animals, and Mother Nature ever since. Whether you're looking for someone to compete with and a title to claim, or just some interesting real stories, there's something within these reference books for you. So today we're going to be taking a look at 10 of the most insane Guinness World Records. Before we get started, don't forget to leave a like if you enjoyed today's video, and please don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. 10. The most expensive dessert in the world. While our first entry may be tame in comparison to a lot of others, the price tag on the frozen hot chocolate ice cream sundae at Serendipity 3 in New York City is not. a blend of 28 different types of cocoa, as well as 5 grams of edible gold, within a golden goblet, also surrounded in edible gold, await you on this sugary treat. The base of the goblet is even wrapped in a bracelet containing white diamonds, and the dessert is served with a golden spoon. The white diamonds and spoon are not edible, so don't get too hungry. Feasting like a king will cost you a pretty penny, as this item costs a whopping $25,000. 9. Most snails on face. In our number 9 spot, we have Finn Kalaer, who was 11 years old at the time of setting the world record for the most snails on someone's face. Claiming it was easier for him because he didn't find snails icky the way most people do, Finn allowed 43 snails to roam his face. Each snail was required to remain on his face for 10 seconds, and Finn had to make 3 different attempts before finally claiming the record. Believing at first that the record was only 8, then coming to find out later that it was actually 36, inspired Finn to reach this comically high number of slimy creatures. 8. Most tricks performed by a pig in 1 minute. Getting on to the oddly specific ones, we have the most tricks performed by a pig in 1 minute. Joy Bleeker, the pig owned by Don Bleeker, set this record when she performed 13 tricks within 1 minute. The tricks included sitting, shaking hands, waiting, ignoring a treat by leaving, going back to take the treat, reversing, dancing, honking, playing the piano, removing a ring, knocking over a pin, picking something up, and rolling a ball. The record was almost 15, but Joy completed one of her tasks before the command, and the other fell just outside of the 60-second mark. 7. Longest human tunnel traveled through by skateboarding dog. Next up, we have one somehow more oddly specific than the last. The longest human tunnel traveled through by a skateboarding dog. A skateboarding bulldog, to be exact, by the name of Otto, from Peru. 30 people stood in a line, facing the same direction, with their feet apart to create the tunnel. Otto was placed on a skateboard at the top of the hill and rode between the legs of all 30 participants without being touched or led. 6. Largest collection of naval fluff. Coming in at number 6, we have the largest collection of naval fluff, also known as belly button lint. If you're grossed out easily, make sure you have a trash can nearby. Removing his naval fluff from his belly button before every shower since he was 19 has made Graham Barker a tad disgusting, but a disgusting world record holder nonetheless. Holding this record for 20 years now, Graham has a collective 22.1 grams of belly button lint across multiple jars at his Australian home. 5. Most layers on a bed of nails sandwich. In Surat, Gujarat, a group of 9 daredevils came together to beat the insane world record of the most layered bed of nails sandwich. The previous record was 8, meaning the group had just enough members to claim the title. Starting with a bed of nails on the bottom and one man on top, they continued the stack vertically, understandably causing a bit more pain for those stuck on the bottom. 4. Farthest eyeball pop. Going back to the gross entries, we have the story of Ken Goodman from Chicago, Illinois. Holding the world record for the furthest eyeball protrusion, she can pop her eyes out of her sockets by 12 millimeters. She noticed that she could do this on cue after it happened the first time from being hit in the head, and says it even happens when she yawns. Not only has Kim made an appearance on The Late Show with David Letterman, she was also featured in the Guinness World Records 50th anniversary list of top 10 feats of all time. 3. Run over by the most trucks. Next up, we have Tom Owen, the man who has been run over by the most vehicles. Tom is a bodybuilder and stuntman who founded the King's Ranch Homes for Children in Alabama. Getting run over by trucks filled with kids for charity events in the past has made Tom no stranger to the stunt or hospital visits. In April of 2009, Tom allowed 9 different pickup trucks to run over his stomach, each of which weighed 3 to 4,000 kilograms, or 6 to 9,000 pounds. As cool as it is to say you've been run over more than anyone else in the world, Tom has unfortunately suffered from broken legs, broken ribs, and liver damage. 2. Youngest person to climb Mount Everest. While many people can say they've climbed Mount Everest, only one person can say they did it at 13. That person is Jordan Romero, from the United States. Accompanied by his father, stepmother, and 3 Sherpas, Jordan was able to finish the grueling climb to the top of the mountain. Additionally, he continued his journey to complete the rest of the 7 summits. The 7 summits are comprised of the highest mountains on each of the 7 continents of the Earth: Everest, Aconcagua, Denali, Kilimanjaro, Elbrus, Mount Vinson, and Karstens Pyramid. He did all of that by the time he reached 15 years old. What did you do when you were 15? Reply in the comments below. 1. First person to break sound barrier during free fall. To wrap up our list, we have the first person to break the sound barrier during free fall. While breaking the sound barrier outside of a vehicle is more of a blue hedgehog thing than a human thing, Felix Baumgartner changed that when he jumped from a hot air balloon in the stratosphere. Not only did he set a world record at the time for skydiving an estimated 39 kilometers, he also broke the sound barrier by reaching an estimated speed of 1,357.64 kilometers per hour, or Mach 1.25. He was literally skydiving at almost 1,000 miles per hour. While most standard views of success correlate to financial and social status, it's always fun to celebrate those with talents on the crazier or weirder side. Is there any world record you'd like to beat, or perhaps already have? Let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed today's video. 10 People Who Survived the Absolutely Impossible. In a society that's obsessed with superhero movies and the concept of immortality, it's no surprise that we enjoy hearing about people who survive things most never could, even if it is a little morbid. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at just that, with 10 people who survived the absolutely impossible. Before we get started, don't forget to leave a like if you enjoyed today's video, and please don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. 10. Dr. Anna Bagenholm. Dr. Anna Bagenholm is a radiologist from Vänersborg, Sweden. In 1999, she was out skiing with some friends when she unfortunately lost control of her skis and fell into a frozen stream near a waterfall. Only her feet and skis remained above the ice, but she managed to find an air pocket to continue breathing while trapped. She remained conscious for 40 minutes while her friends attempted to help and call for help. Although her body temperature dropped so low, she experienced circulatory arrest. A rescue team attempted to pull her out with a rope and tried using a snow shovel to save Anna, but both attempts were unsuccessful. Another team of rescuers arrived with a pointed gardening shovel, which could break the ice, and finally Anna was free after 80 minutes of this icy nightmare. Dr. Anna Bagenholm survived after medical professionals pumped her blood through a special machine meant to warm it up, and while she was left with a permanent tingling sensation in her hands, she had no long-lasting brain damage after the incident. 9. Aaron Ralston. Aaron Ralston is a mechanical engineer, born in October of 1975. While attempting a solo descent into Blue John Canyon on April 26, 2003, he dislodged a boulder, which trapped one of his hands against the canyon wall. Aaron hadn't informed anyone of his plans to go hiking and had no means of communication to call for help. Making various attempts to remove his hand from the 800-pound boulder over a three-day period, Aaron would sip his small portion of water and ration the mere two burritos he brought along for the trip, but ultimately couldn't break free. Aaron realized amputating his arm was the only option and experimented with tourniquets until realizing that to get out of this situation, he was going to have to cut through the bone, but he didn't have the tools to do so. On the fifth day, Aaron was all out of food, water, and hope. He carved his name and assumed death date into the wall and videotaped his final goodbye to his family. During that night, though, he hallucinated himself playing with his future child and missing one arm. Aaron refers to this hallucination as the event that gave him hope he'd survive. Using tourniquet, a dull pocket knife, and an unspecified multi-tool, Aaron managed to tear off his now decomposing arm before rappelling down the canyon and making the 8-mile journey back to his car. 6 miles along the way, however, he encountered a family who gave him food and water and alerted the authorities. 8. Uruguayan Air Force Flight 571. On October 13, 1972, Uruguayan Air Force Flight 571 crashed into a mountain due to the co-pilot descending early after mistakenly believing the flight had reached its destination. Both wings, as well as the tail, were removed from the plane in the incident, and the remainder of the plane and its 45 passengers came down to rest on a glacier. From the crash itself, the harsh temperatures, and other injuries, 3 crew members, as well as more than a quarter of the passengers, died in the crash. Authorities searched for the wreckage for 8 days before giving up as the white fuselage blended in with the snow. 13 more died over the next 72 days, and others survived by eventually turning to cannibalism. 2 survivors, Nando Parado and Roberto Canessa, climbed through the Andes Mountains over a 10-day period to find help. They made their way into Chile, despite their lack of climbing gear, on December 23, 1972, and 16 survivors were rescued. 7. Janelle Guzman McMillan. September 11, 2001 is an important moment in American history, as it was the day of the World Trade Center attacks. Janelle Guzman McMillan is one of the survivors of this tragic event, however, and continues to happily share her story to give the world hope. Janelle said it was like she could feel the walls caving in before she was pinned underneath steel and cement and prayed to God to help her. After being trapped for a whopping 27 hours, a heroic 4-legged furry friend sniffed her out and led her to safety. Dogs really are humanity's best friends, huh? 6. Truman Duncan. In June 2006, Truman Duncan slipped and fell onto the train tracks while riding on the front of a train car. Truman said he started running backwards as fast as he could, but he just couldn't make it in time and was inevitably hit by a train. He was pulled under the rail car and dragged 75 feet across the tracks before the train finally came to a stop, leaving his body almost cut in half. His body just barely remained intact through one muscle connecting his torso to his leg. After managing to reach his cell phone and call 911, the authorities arrived 62 minutes later and flew him to the Texas Health Hospital. The incident may have resulted in Truman having to go through multiple surgeries over the next month and a half, but through sheer willpower and thoughts of his family, he managed to stay alive. 5. Anatoly Bogorsky. Anatoly Bogorsky was a researcher at the Institute for High Energy Physics in Protvino when he was checking out a piece of malfunctioning equipment. He reportedly stuck his head in the path of the 76 GeV proton beam when he saw a flash that he described as brighter than a thousand suns, though he did not feel any pain. Due to this, the left side of his face started to swell up so much it was unrecognizable, and the skin started to peel. Despite being expected to die, Anatoly survived and even completed his PhD, but he lost hearing in his left ear, experienced occasional seizures, and half of his face paralyzed because of the incident. 4. Mauro Prosperi. Mauro Prosperi is an Italian police officer who took part in the 1994 Marathon des Sables in Morocco. 6 days in during this marathon, a sandstorm started, causing him to get disoriented and begin running in the wrong direction. After just 24 hours, he ran out of all his food and water and resorted to drinking his own urine. Luckily, he also discovered an abandoned Muslim shrine after a while, which had bats in it, that he drank the blood of to stay hydrated. A helicopter and plane passed over him, but unfortunately neither saw him. Mauro assumed he was going to die anyways, and to save himself from a long and painful death, tried cutting his wrists, but he was so dehydrated that his blood started to clot, making it an unsuccessful attempt. After regaining his composure and continuing to trek through the desert, he eventually discovered an oasis with people who fed him and was ultimately taken to a hospital. 3. Greg Rasmussen. Greg Rasmussen is a British wildlife conservation biologist and is the founder of the Painted Dog Conservation. In 2003, he was involved in a plane crash that left him in the African bush, alone and injured, but not dead. Dehydrated, in pain, and surrounded by animals who could easily make him their dinner, Greg camped out under the wreck of his plane for 27 hours. Rescuers eventually found him and took him back to safety, but he did still lose both of his feet because of the incident. 2. Hiro Onoda. Hiro Onoda was an Imperial Japanese Army intelligence officer who fought in World War II. Onoda was instructed to resist until the end during his time serving in the Philippines, causing him not to surrender until almost 30 years after the war had ended. Onoda shot cows, stole rice, and occasionally killed the locals while living in the jungle to survive all that time until he was finally given an official order to end his conflict. 1. Frayn Szélak. Frayn Szélak has quite the long list of fatal incidents that he managed to survive to tell the tale of. From surviving a train crashing into a river, being pulled out of a malfunctioning plane door, being thrown into another river after a bus slid off of the road, escaping his car as it caught on fire, and being thrown out of another car door and holding onto a tree as his car plummeted 300 feet into a gorge. Despite many other people dying in these incidents, Frayn managed to walk away from each one with pretty minor injuries all things considered, and won the lottery in 2013, almost like the universe was apologizing for all he had been through. This concludes our video on 10 people who survived the absolutely impossible. If you enjoyed today's video, please leave a like and don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. Thanks for watching. Top 10 beautiful tourist destinations that we destroyed. We are currently in the month of April. School is almost out and summer is fast approaching, which means plenty of fun family summer vacations. However, there is a pandemic going around, forcing many people to cancel that vacation that you've been looking forward to for so long. So to make you feel a little better about missing that vacation, I'll be counting down the top 10 destroyed tourist locations that you can't visit anyway. More specifically, the only locations on this list are landmarks destroyed by only humans. This will be excluding places destroyed by natural disasters. So now with that out of the way, let's get into the video. Number 10. The Notre Dame Cathedral. Notre Dame de Paris, referred to simply as Notre Dame, is the largest Gothic Aria cathedral in all of France. However, quite recently on the 15th of April 2019, a mysterious fire broke out within the chapel while it was under repairs. What makes this tragedy so perplexing is to this day, no one really knows who or what started the fire. Either way, Disney predicted it in The Hunchback of Notre Dame. Number 9. The Namal Pyramid. The Namal Pyramid is a 2,300-year-old Mayan pyramid. It was destroyed in 2013 by the Damar Stone Company using bulldozers. Their reasoning for doing this was because they wanted the limestone that the pyramid was made from. In this case, the limestone from this pyramid was used to fill roads with gravel in a nearby town. Fortunately, the foul crooks behind DeMar's Stone Company got what they deserved. After an investigation, the excavator driver, the foreman, and two of the company's managing directors were punished with fines. Serves them right, honestly. Number 8. Antarctica. While this is not an extremely popular tourist attraction, it is still one that people visit. If you ask me, I do not know why more people aren't visiting Antarctica. Dangerous snowstorms, an average temperature of 14 degrees Fahrenheit, what's not to love? On that basis, even if you're a crazy person who would find that appealing, I would highly suggest not going to Antarctica, as it is slowly melting, making it increasingly unstable and unsafe. Scientists link this melting to global warming, which is considered by some to be controversial. Nonetheless, whether you believe in global warming or not, Antarctica is still melting, and it's probably our fault, because humanity is the worst. Number 7. The Great Wall of China. Now I can already hear you typing in the comments that the Great Wall of China is not destroyed. You can still visit it to this day. While that is correct, it's only partly correct. Two-thirds of the wall have been destroyed. Yes, it's not fully destroyed and you can still visit it, but over half of the wall is gone. The cause of this is just from it being overused. The Great Wall of China is one of the most popular tourist locations in the world, and over the course of its lifetime, it's taken a lot of wear and tear just from walking on it, as well as people taking small pieces from it as souvenirs. It does not sound like much, but over time it starts adding up. Number 6. Nelson's Pillar. Nelson's Pillar in Dublin was a monument erected out of respect to Lord Nelson. The pillar was built in 1808 and was made from black limestone. Unfortunately, it was considered quite controversial. Many people said it was a symbol of British imperialism. But the bigger issue people had with it was that it blocked automotive traffic. It was a bit of a lazy excuse, but it was enough to get the government to consider moving it. However, after debates regarding whether it should be removed, the pillar remained, leaving many people upset. In 1966, IRA groups succeeded in planting a bomb that destroyed the upper half of the pillar. Army engineers were forced to blow up the rest of the pillar 6 days later, judging it too damaged to save. To think that an entire landmark was destroyed because it slightly disrupted traffic. Number 5. Babylon. The ruins of Babylon were in present-day Iraq and have remained undisturbed for a while. This all changed in 2003 when the United States of America declared war on Iraq and invaded them. In 2007, it was confirmed that American armed forces had converted Nebuchadnezzar's great city of Babylon into a 150-hectare camp for 2,000 troops. In the process, the Ishtar Gate was damaged by tanks, and the brick pavement leading up to the gate was destroyed. The rich soil of the city was bulldozed to fill sandbags. Ever since then, Babylon has been considered to be archaeologically barren, as anything that could have been there has been destroyed. Number 4. Maya Bay in Phi Phi Island, Thailand. Home to a magnificent white sand beach, azure waters, and stunning towering cliffs, Maya Bay has seen a massive influx of tourists after being the primary location for the film The Beach, starring Leonardo DiCaprio. This popular tourist destination has had more than 1 million tourists visit each year. About 200 boats stop by every day to drop off the 6,000 tourists that visit, severely crippling the ecosystem in the area. The pollution from the boats, littering, and sunscreen have destroyed 90% of the coral reefs that surround the bay. As a result, officials have closed off the entire bay on June 1, 2019, saying that it's been completely destroyed. It is bound to reopen again for tourists in 2021, with hopes that the ecosystem is recovered by that time. Number 3. The Eiffel Tower. The Eiffel Tower is possibly the most iconic Parisian landmark. Surprisingly, it was almost never even constructed at all. The public protested the structure before it was built, concerned over both the cost and fears that it would be an eyesore on the city's skyline. It was eventually completed in 1889 and was meant to serve only as a temporary fixture that would be dismantled after 20 years. But its value as a radio telegraph station ended up saving it from such destruction until World War II. While the Eiffel Tower never was destroyed, it came awfully close to it. When the Nazis took over France in World War II, General Dietrich von Schultitzby was instructed by Adolf Hitler to destroy Paris, including the Eiffel Tower. Thankfully, he disobeyed those orders. Historians still debate on the reason Dietrich did, as it sounds strange that he would disobey a direct command. One thing is for sure, the Eiffel Tower still stands strong. Number 2. The Colosseum of Rome. The Colosseum is among the best-known structures in the world, as well as being one of the oldest structures in the world. Due to this, the structure has been slowly falling apart. If that wasn't bad enough, it gets worse. In the 6th century, following the fall of the Roman Empire, the landmark was pillaged for building materials. It was not until the 18th century when Pope Benedict XIV consecrated the Colosseum as a church. Ever since then, the Colosseum has remained untouched. Number 1. Jerusalem. The old city of Jerusalem, whose walls were also built by Suleiman the Magnificent, was taken by Jordanian forces during the 1948 Israeli-Arab League War. It is home to several sites of religious importance and is traditionally divided into four areas: the Jewish, Muslim, Armenian, and Christian quarters. It is alleged that 34 of 35 synagogues were deliberately destroyed during the Jordanian occupation, including the 300-year-old Herva Synagogue. Upon retaking the old city in 1967, Israeli forces destroyed what was once the Moroccan quarter. The old city became a World Heritage Site in 1981 at the request of Jordan. And there you have it. Those were our picks for the top 10 tourist locations we have destroyed. Have you heard of any of these famous locations? Are there any more important locations you think we missed? If so, leave a comment about it below. If you enjoyed today's video, make sure to leave a like and remember to subscribe if you enjoy our content. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Top 10 Richest Rappers in the World. While hip-hop music can be about storytelling, expressing one's emotions, or just having a good time, bragging about the amount of money one has is a pretty common occurrence within the genre. Some hits are about nothing but that, like Money by Cardi B or Got Money by Lil Wayne and T-Pain. We're going to be taking a look at the rappers who actually have the money where their mouth is in today's video, the top 10 richest rappers in the world. Before we get started, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and thanks for watching. 10. Birdman. Brian Williams, more commonly known as Birdman, founded Cash Money Records with his brother Ronald, a record label that would go on to sign superstars such as Lil Wayne. Birdman himself was a rapper and record producer, as well as an investor and entrepreneur. While his solo work isn't as popular as it once was, and his name not as recognizable as some of his future prodigies, being the man in charge has kept some money flowing into his pockets. Birdman's estimated net worth comes in right around $100 million. 9. Lil Wayne. Whether you're a hip-hop head, the occasional listener, or a straight-up hater, you probably know who Lil Wayne is. Signing to Cash Money Records when he was just 13 years old, and still releasing albums to this day, Lil Wayne has quite a large amount of experience under his belt. Not only has he appeared in multiple movies over the span of his career, but he's spent a lot of time working with and building up other artists, like Eminem and Drake, who both ended up becoming even more successful than Wayne. Despite his apprentices rising and becoming the masters, Lil Wayne still has a dedicated fan base and some fat pockets, with his net worth coming in at an estimated $120 million. 8. Snoop Dogg. Calvin Cordozar Broaddus Jr., more commonly known as Snoop Dogg, is a hip-hop artist and Mary Jane enthusiast from California. Snoop Dogg is much more complex than that, however, as singer, songwriter, producer, actor, and entrepreneur are just some of the other titles Snoop carries. Dropping albums from rap to reggae, appearing in a slew of TV shows and movies, and strategic investing has helped Snoop make his way onto this list, with his net worth coming in at an estimated $135 million. 7. Pharrell. Next up, we have someone who frequently collaborates with Snoop, Pharrell Williams, or more commonly referred to as just Pharrell. Whether you're one of the few die-hard nerd fans, a drop-it-like-it's-hot enthusiast, or a mom that can't get her kids to stop listening to Happy on repeat, chances are you've heard of Pharrell. Between writing for multiple artists, pumping out his own music in multiple genres, and owning a media venture, Pharrell has made quite the living for himself, coming in at an estimated $150 million. 6. Master P. Percy Robert Miller, more commonly known as Master P, is a rapper, actor, record producer, and former basketball player. Releasing multiple songs, appearing in multiple films, and starting a record label seem to be the frequent keys to success, as that's how Master P got rich, much like most other artists on today's list. He also owns his own entire basketball league, the Global Mixed Gender Basketball League, or GMGB. His numerous ventures leave him at number 6 on our list, coming in at an estimated $200 million net worth. 5. Eminem. Marshall Mathers, stage name Eminem, is one of the most successful mainstream artists of all time. Between his evil persona's love for controversy and his ability to rap faster than most people can talk, he's kept all eyes on him for a pretty long time. While he does have other projects, such as his hit movie 8 Mile, his 100 million album sales would have been enough to get him on this list alone. The original creator of Stan Culture comes in at number 5, with an estimated net worth of $210 million. 4. Diddy. Puff Daddy, P. Diddy, Sean Combs, the list goes on. Regardless of what you'd like to call him, Diddy gets things done. Whether you've seen him hosting one of many TV shows, heard him referenced by another artist, or heard one of the tracks off of his 7-time platinum album No Way Out, you've probably come across Diddy's work somewhere. Diddy has been nominated for and received awards from BET, MTV, and the NAACP for his acting and music. Diddy comes in at number 4 on our list, with a number that's a pretty far cry from number 3, an estimated net worth of $740 million. 3. Dr. Dre. Starting off our top 3, we have Andre Young, more commonly known as Dr. Dre. Young is a rapper, producer, actor, entrepreneur, and just generally a man with an eye for talent. Appearing on and producing songs with other huge artists, like Snoop Dogg and Tupac, back in the day, had Dre rolling in dough pretty fast. But things would only be uphill from there. Practically presenting Eminem and 50 Cent to the world, and being inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, due to his role in N.W.A., both attributed to Dre's legendary status. Dre comes in right at number 3, with an estimated net worth of $800 million. 2. Kanye West. Whether you love to hate him or you just plain love him, if you clicked on this video, you've probably had conversations about Kanye West. Despite the questionable statements both in and out of his music, people love controversy, and Kanye loves to give it to them. From making albums that are viewed as classics within the hip-hop community, like the 2010s album of the decade, My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy, to appearing on talk shows to say random nonsense, Kanye keeps busy. Not to mention his other half's reality TV show and beauty products. Surprisingly, most of his money isn't actually from rapping. It's from his apparel and footwear line Yeezy. Kanye's estimated net worth comes in at a whopping $1.3 billion, giving him our number 2 spot. 1. Jay-Z. Coming in at the number 1 spot is Jay-Z, also known as Sean Carter. Married to the equally as rich and arguably more famous Beyoncé, Jay-Z is a rapper, actor, record producer, investor, and entrepreneur from the home of hip-hop, Brooklyn, New York. Releasing solo albums, making albums alongside Kanye West, creating his own record label, investing in art, and starting his own music streaming platform are just some of the things Jay-Z did to grow his wealth. Being a businessman first and foremost, and an entertainer second, has paid off for Mr. Carter, with his net worth alone coming in at an estimated $1.5 billion. This concludes today's video on the top 10 richest rappers in the world. Did the list pan out the way you thought it would? Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoyed today's video, please leave a like, don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching.